Okay. So I'm not going to be super entertaining here, but I'm working on a playthrough. Basically, I want to make Outer Wilds the movie. And so I'm working on what needs to happen in each sort of each episode. And I think what I'm going to... Oh, this is like heavy Outer Wild spoilers, by the way. Maybe I should add some text. Anyway. Yeah, so we're gonna go through this. It's not going to be super entertaining because I'm basically just putting my PC through its paces and working on this. So I'm not going to check chat too often. Can I pop this out? There we go. But you're welcome to talk to me if you want. Let's tweet this. That's not right. Sure. Great. Okay, so I'm going to play through this as if I was actually doing it. So we're going to start by exploring the village. We're going to, you know, say hi to, or see where Feldspar is. We're going to go to the museum. And then we're going to check out the Bramble Seed and then the Quantum Grove. And then hit Addle Rock. Learn about the quantum moon locator and check out the Southern Observatory and, you know, say hi to Esker. Okay. So this is kind of fun because the game is actually locked to 60 frames per second. But it says it's running in the 90s, it actually isn't. It's lying. Only less likely. So. Oh, Q Andy, advance the text. Okay. So he's got... Oh, man, I forgot about this crouching bug. You start crouching, then you stop crouching. Is that everywhere? Yeah. I don't know why it does that. But he's got two... Or they, because they're a genderless species. They've got two goggles and not four. Four goggle lenses. Okay. To mouse input, which is not clear to me that was how this works. tipping over and then you're done, because it doesn't autocorrect. Okay. So I don't know if anybody else, but the very first thing I noticed was glass in the color space. Serendipitous kind of stuff that you end up. you do by accident, but it just feels really good. It's kind of on my new computer. So I originally played this on my MacBook. Very high full. Nice. And so I'm running this guy in highest res, super solid. So playing this game on my MacBook, I had everything turned way down. I was still getting just very few frames per second. So, I think what I want to do, since text kind of pause the game, I think I want to, in this walkthrough, include a decent amount of text. I want to talk as little as possible. Because for me, it made me jump through the normal like tutorial. Not, I mean, it's not a tutorial, but like the normal walkthrough. So I think we're gonna skip it. I think we'll figure out how to use the signal scope. Otherwise, I don't think we need to do this. for the first episode, well, each episode will be the same. That works out in the playthrough. I hope we get to see the moon kind of disappear. But we're obviously going to have to die a couple times, so the first episode, or each episode is going to try to be 22 minutes long, but some of them are going to be a little off. But this first episode can be as long as we want because the timing doesn't run. The star countdown doesn't start. Man, this is so much better in full res. You can just see everything. Full texture resolution, and then it's full res on my monitor. Oh, this is such a great little storytelling. So the way that most people die the first time is either jumping in the geyser or jumping straight into the ghost matter. This is a great way to learn this. We're gonna have to do this in the tutorial. Then he won't talk to you anymore. I love it. Used to having a computer that can power through this. I'm guessing the game is probably coming around there. All right. Okay. So let's. We got zero dropped frames. Oh, I keep doing it. There we go. Okay, I don't like this. This little game is not fun. Like, I get that it's... I get that it's, you know, trying to teach you how to use a tool. I think it's boring. I don't know if I'm going to put in the walkthrough. But if I don't, I should have done. That's cool. I'm not going to get that many people watching this anyway. Okay. So I do want to do the signal scope tutorial. Oh, that's the quantum. Where is James? So that's the direction. That's the harmonica. That's the direction of the seed. And then being able to target Asker would be nice. So here's like the game breaking issue is that this guy doesn't wake up until a certain point in the story. You have to get the launch codes before this will work, because that's when time starts. So gameplay wise it makes a lot of sense, but lore wise it makes no sense. I'm assuming the other people are too. So at the end of the game we're going to need to reference this again. So we really need to bookend the first and last episodes. I don't know a good way to call that out. Okay, so this is, so if we're talking about the eye, oh, quantum moon locator. Nope. It's not a, oops, dang it, it's not a quantum moon locator. One. It's episode one. How do we... Oh, this is not supposed to be here. Who's missing a one? Okay, well this... oops. This needs to get moved down to maybe this episode, I'm not sure. Okay, locate Feldspar. Learn from the museum that they're from our past. So that's kind of what we're doing now. We'll check out the Dark Bramble Seed. Check out the Quantum Grove. And go to Addle Rock. I don't know if we can do all this in one loop. Okay. But we're seeing that, yeah, there will be something interesting. Okay, so I guess this would be the first time that we're... No, so we have to make sure to stop here. An ancient species, there we go. Okay, so this is like the intro to the Novi. I guess this would be 2.5. Okay. So this is an ATP issue, even though it's referring to Giant's Deep. So I think going around this way is the way to do it, so we can start with the Nomai. Such good flavor text. Surprisingly, only for your eyes. So we're learning a lot here that we're going to have to reference later, so it kind of makes for an interesting first episode where we just get a bunch of info that the viewer doesn't have to remember, but, you know, presumably they would remember a little bit and then rediscover the mechanics. Is that how it works? Oh, what's this crazy thing? To be fantastic is okay. It is good, you know. This is a cool one, but it just, the demo takes so long. Just so pretty. Okay, so we don't want to say that because we don't want to. I want to keep the cues as straightforward as possible. So I want to lean towards Giant's Deep cues. No one's explored there. Well, that's not true. That's good, a good intro to the lore. I really wish we could look through the telescope. So there's a way to get out of here without activating the statue. Our 22-minute timer. Oh, you know, I thought that there were more people here after that happened. Maybe that's in the next loop. That was bizarre. Oh, that's a really good way to get him. Say hi for him. So the first time I played, I don't think I came through here. I think I brute forced it and just ran straight towards the ship. I like that this thing goes up and down, but it's like useless. Because we want to go this way anyway. Twins. Yep, they're transferring. Okay. So we'll have to look around the ship a little bit. Check out our kit. Oh, we forgot to discover Feldspar. Or not Feldspar. What's his name? Hornfels. I guess we should probably fly to the south pole. Thank you. Hey, Gabe. You got your police shout out. Discover the southern, so we did that. Six. Okay. Yeah, so we do need to be able to go through these steps. Oh, Gabe didn't get a shout out quick enough. So we do need to go through those steps if we want to eat up the 22 minutes after the first. I don't think that this route shows us any, oh, it's just that one. Okay, so it doesn't show us any live anglerfish. And then we stick, and it's such a great camera angle. I did it such a great job with this. Okay. So we do that. What else did we want to do? 3, 4, Quantum Grove. Do I know what this crater is? It's probably the end of one of the, geyser tunnels. Oh, okay. So this is how we'll do this approach. So I don't know how we're gonna play this one out, because I want it to feel really organic, right? Because the first time you find this, it's just super confusing. So for those things, I think we can really slow down. Just have a really long first episode, I guess. Man, it's so bizarre to me that I can actually stream pretty high quality without any effort. Okay. 6. Yeah. Okay, so this is just dark bramble. And so the only other thing to do on... is to do the geyser networks. I'm going to do those later. So I know that there's one on Giant's Deep. I don't know where the other ones are. Ice sure looks like the interloper, doesn't it? I would be shocked if that wasn't intentional. So maybe the interloper smacked into Battle Rock at some point. Okay, alright. So, I guess what we need to do is walk around Addle Rock instead of fly around Addle Rock, and that'll get us pretty close to the end of the world. Yeah, we can see the course. This is going to happen anytime now. And then, hopefully we'll get lucky enough to be able to end the episode looking at the sun. And, yeah, I'd really like the first episode to end with that. Okay, so what we should do then is, so 4, 5, hang out on, okay, bang head on a rock. Look for signals, as he suggests. And he says go to the southern, or to the eye. Oh, no, he says to go to the North Pole, which is where the that little platform is. So we can do that. Five, six. That isn't a quantum moon. We're really going to have to take our time with this if we want. If we want this timing to work out. Side. That's just cam. So yeah, it says I'm running around 100 frames per second, but that is not true. We are locked to 60 frames per second because that's how long the physics tick is. And I believe that other... Ooh, it's a good shadow. That other Unity games don't have that issue. Oof, such good attention to detail. Is his lantern blue? Was the lantern in the Zero G cave blue as well? take our time, because that's not a lot. I need to set a timer, really, is what I need to do. I guess if worse comes to worse, I can always just hang a lantern out and say, hey, that's enough for the first episode, we're going to sit here and just watch? I don't know. I really want it to feel like a player's first run through. Episode 2, with the over gravity cannon. Okay, so we just saw it launch, so we can go. Okay, well, let's go check that out. Do a quick fly around to show the structure, land on the pad, and enter, look down the barrel, read the three signs, enter the control module, grab projection stone, take a look at the launch module, note how stone symbols work. Oh, yeah. Read the launch module stone, learn more about the search for the eye. Giant steep stone. So we're gonna fly around, enter control module, projection of the launch module, read launch module. Giant's Deep and view Giant's Deep. And go to launch module. Okay. And then we'll visit the construction yard. Okay. Let's see how this time. This is mostly just for timing. Thank you. So enter into a higher orbit so that we can see this station fly beneath us and catch up to it. Let it catch up to us. This is one of the few times when you really feel the height because you're so close to the planet. As soon as I hit the ball, to just not move the camera so that it's real obvious what's going on. So I wrote down, look down the barrel first. I think that's a good idea. So before we start reading, I'm gonna just look through this window. Because the view really is pretty great. So we're going to do projection stuff. Thank you. So I'd like to run up. Module. So I already started work on the script, but the timing is really hard to work out if you're on a PC. And now I'm not. Heights thing just gets real bad when you're out here without a ship. first clue of where the probe tracker module is. And it's not a great clue. They did the interior of the core cell.
Okay.
Gravity reverser, where is it? It's supposed to be over here. Construction yard. So we can just go straight back to the ship. No need to go back inside. Construction yard. So not talking to Gabbro first. That's the right order to be there. Thank you. first instead of going to the side that was missing the stone, then find it and backtracking. I guess we'll see about timing of the episode and see if that backtrack feels like a natural way to stretch out the 22 minutes. These first couple of loops have to look really good. But after that, okay, so we want to read this first. Time. Try to dive beneath.
Thank you.
Alright, so there's the first two episodes. I think those are pretty well planned out. Jeez, go away. I thought it was one of the F buttons hit the UI. Oh, now it says reset loop. Oh, that's nice. Oh, maybe that actually was from the beginning. Okay. Alrighty, I'm feeling pretty good about that. And I'm feeling really good about the way that this streaming went. This is, like, so easy. It's really good. Yeah, alright. Thanks, folks. At some point, I would like to do some actual streaming, but this was mostly just playing around with stuff and seeing what I could do.